Owl, and welcome back to our Minecraft Let's Play Old World Revived. Yeah, lots of things have changed, many big changes. Yeah, that one still doesn't work. Might as well, as you can see there, I've done a little bit of remodeling, but yeah, most of it is also inside. Hey, how you doing, Willy? This is Willy, my beekeeper. So yeah, as you can see, the staircase is gone. All of the chests I had here in front are gone, on the side and stuff like that. Yeah, and also we have ourselves a little map of our little town here, whatever you want to call it, my little piece of heaven. So yeah, tons of things have happened. Also, new mods have come out. Let me just see here. You guys, most of you know that I am running the Direwolf 20s mod packs, right? But many of you don't know that I'm also running the beta testing for Direwolf 20 as well. You're probably wondering, you don't know Direwolf 20? Actually, I do. I have been allowed to tell you that. yeah, but I'm not on the Forge the Forgecraft 2 server thing. I have signed myself up to be one of the beta testers and one of the testers and stuff like that, but I haven't been lucky enough to be granted access to it yet. But so I can beta test his mod pack instead. Some new things, some new things have been added. For one thing, what is it? I think it is extra utilities. It's not new, but new things has been added on. Also, Mistcraft have gotten something, have got some new programming done. What is it? Botanica is getting some new flowers. These normal white flowers here can even become higher flowers, and you need a special tool in order to get them all. If you just destroy it, you will only get one normal flower. What else? Yeah, of course. Direwolf being Direwolf wants his freaking portal gun mod. So portal gun 2.0 is on here. It doesn't say portal gun 2. It doesn't say any number in front of this in here. But yeah, this is portal gun 2.0. We got some portal multi-block name. This is a special type of deal where you just walk on it and it teleports you to whichever block this thing is linked to. I think this also works with computer craft, where you can just click on the screen as Direwolf 20 usually does. But yeah, he wanted his portal guns in, not his portal gun, but the portal gun mod in. So of course the author of the portal gun said, okay, I'll work harder, and we got it in. Also, Asinor. Double click the mods in order to get them all. Asinor, the founder of wait a minute. No, let me just think. Is it Asinor or is it who is the I can't quite remember it, but we're getting equivalent exchange 2, guys. We're giving no 3 actually, sorry, that's the third installment. Equivalent Exchange 3, and no, it's not Asinor, it's somebody, it's someone else, but I can't quite remember his name. It just lost me for a second there. But yeah, he has been working hard on a special program that when you install Equivalent Exchange 3 onto a mod that's already full of mod packs, or in a world that they have played a lot of a ton of, it will use it has a special program that it just calculates all the numeric values of blocks. And for you can check it out. A link will be in the description for the new series that Direwolf 20 is doing on Forgecraft 2, on the server Forgecraft 2 Season 7. A new episode is out already. You can check in the description below. It will be there. And yeah, they are talking about all the new mods that are gonna come on and stuff like that. Of course, they're gonna come on first on Forgecraft servers. That's their main tasting base. And then Direwolf will then add the ones he wants onto his mod list. Whew, big mouthful right there. But yeah, let me just give you a little tour here. Oh, ow, ow, ow. Yeah, oh. That's F7. That little X there underneath the flowers there, that's to indicate where mobs can spawn. Yeah, so I made two new golems. A harvest slash planting golem. So he's gonna go up and take all of the ender pearls when they are fully mature. But the cool thing is about it is, he knows the way he is programmed. He knows exactly when to take the ender pearl, when it would yield not only the pearl and a seed, but an additional seed. So you can see here, I've got 12 ender lily pads, ender lily seeds right here. Last time we left off, I only had 9. So yeah. And then that other guy there, he just goes around, picks them up, and puts them in that chest. But that chest is up top of a hopper, which then ports them in here, so I can just take them in here. Hey. Yeah, after we've got enough cactus, and we got this one on the floor here, so I'm just voiding them in order to get my number 2 of these, of this one, the singularity, the condensed singularity thing. I want that singularity so bad. Okay. Yeah, doesn't matter. Okay. Plans for the future, for the future weeks coming, is that... Oh. Yeah. Oh, yeah. It goes all the way up and all the way down, of course. We need more power. The capacitor bank here, I've made another one, but... oh yeah, this is one too, the Ender IO. Here, let me show you. E-N-D-E-R, oh, sorry. Ah, come on. E-N-D-E-R, Ender IO. If you look up here, this capacitor bank here is still in the mod because it's telling you that it is being deleted. This version of the capacitor bank is being deleted from the mods. From the Ender IO mod, because a new one is already implemented here. This capacitor bank right here. It's the same one. Capacitor bank, 5 million. 5 million. It's the same one. It's just that the new one has a little bit more in the info text. For example, you can see here, I'm looking at the capacitor bank. It has 5 million RF. 5 million RF, but down here when it says hold shift, it says 10,000 RF. That is because it is one of a conjoined set of capacitor banks. We have two, meaning we get 10,000 RF. I can click on it and it will say 10,000, or it has 10 million and it says 10,000 RF per tick in and out. And you can, I can put in my BAM and it will start, yeah. As you can see here, it says minus, wrong one, yeah, sometimes here, RF per tick. This one up here doesn't do that much because it's the other one, capacitor bank down here, that's doing all the work. But yeah, this thing is getting slowly charged up. These two lava things here are working their ass off at the moment. So yeah, but I need more power to my system. You're probably wondering, why do you need more power to your system? Well, if the one of you with a concerning eye will already see that we're missing something from this picture right here. Yep, that's right. We are missing the two drive the two ME drive ports right here, where I had all my hard drives in it for memory storage and stuff like that. Yeah, then you're probably wondering, but where is it now? Well, I am currently working on a very high-tech tree down here. As you can see here, we got all the drives in here. Thus far it is working correct. I'm using, this tree here is thought of by King Daddy D-Mac. I'm using his layout here in order to get this up and running, but it consumes too much power. So, as it is now, it's cool. I can see whatever it's in these, as you can see here, bam, no problem there, right? I can see whatever in these drives here. But if I connect up the purple line that you can see behind here, if I connect up the purple line, it consumes too much power. Because the way this is set up is I can see what's in the drives right here, but the purple line, which is this one right here, I can see the drives. Would you scram, freaking spider? This one is dark now because there's no power to the purple line. But yeah, here I would not be able to see it like this. But instead I will see all of the drives that's inside, or all of the hard disks that's inside the ME drives here, because the drives is hooked up with a, what is this thing called again? It's the storage bus, yeah. It's a storage bus that's hooked up to the ME drive. That can see how many hard drives that's inside the drive tower or drive bay or whatever you want to call it. 64k storage hard disks. I call them hard disks, hard drives. Yeah, 64k's. Yeah, this one can see all of these inside of it, where the blue line gives me what's inside the hard disks. Okay, and I'm also building this one up here. This is also one from King Daddy D-Max. I am completely into his Let's Play and stuff like that. I don't know if I have done it the right way. Let me just check the footage. Yeah, it's done the right way. I have his video over here on the other screen. But yeah, I'm going to build the, let me see here, I think it's this one, right? Nope, that's the wrong one. There's the black one. Yeah. I'm gonna convert from lava generators to potion generators instead. Apparently, the way, what I've set up so far, I already have the things I needed. We have nether warts, we have gunpowder, we have sugar. Where do we have our gunpowder? G-U-N. We got 5k gunpowder. Damn, that's right up here. And also we got the glowstone. We got tons and tons of glowstone. So I was like thinking, I could do that. I could make this system here and stuff, so we can get more power in. Yep. And yeah, another little gathering golem down here for my wart farm, and a what is called a vacuum chest from Ender.io to vacuum in all this stuff. I had actually made a gatherer golem and a harvest golem. He's the harvest golem, sorry.
Shut up!
Let's get out of here. Yeah. How you doing, Willy? Okay, out here. This big boy right here. This thing here is also set up to my Ender system, which is why we have all of those my Emmy system is why we have all of these 5K blaze rod, 1,100 of these, and why we have all of the gunpowder and the sugar is because we got spawners up the wazoo in here. And of course behind them is a couple of grinders, as you can see there. They are just grinding away, these grinders here. And as soon as the idle stops, boom, they're dead. And I just stand here and let it go for, well, a couple of hours and stuff like that. So yeah. Oh, a sticky witch was ground to bits. A fiery blaze was ground to bits. So yeah. I'm using the drawbridge block upstairs with wireless redstone, and yeah, it's just deploying a ton of glowstone blocks, so it turns off the spawners, because those are the vanilla spawners. They spawn when I am in the vicinity, and as you can see, we have got tons and tons of essence. We have gotten more than we need. Oh. Dude, just because I got a, they are attracted to Willy for some unknown reason, but yeah, oh well. Let us go upstairs and have a look. Okay, let me just toss these in here. Here we go. Actually, from the mini-map there, you can see it actually looks like some kind of creature laying there. But that's just the glowstone connecting to all of these here, right here. So, if I were to take this one away. I don't know why it has so many, so much glowstone. Oh well. Yeah. Oh well. Well, that doesn't matter. I don't know why it has so much glowstone, but what the fuck. Oh well. Yeah, I don't know why either it didn't retract, but apparently it needs to... yeah. Ah, the signal for this one. It didn't retract because the signal hits this one, the block, then refers the signal to this one. So if I do this, we actually don't need these two. Nope. As soon as I do this, course, carpenter's garage door, pretty cool. So, yeah, my intention with this and all the essence is I'm going to make special types of spawners right here. Oh, God damn it. Yeah, for example, the wisp spawner and the maybe even a what is it called? A wither skeleton spawner, yeah. So we can get the withers, because I want to kill a couple, or actually I want to kill 4 withers. Because as you can see here, I have made the platforms tier 5 of this altar here. Needs the vanilla beacon thingies. So yeah, I've already sacrificed the diamond to make these platforms here. And we got this brewing stand as well. And then we got bees. I've also started on bees, of course. Ooh, let's see here. And I've made myself some new pouches that can hold a lot more. Okay. Ooh, this is good. This is good. We are steadily but surely upgrading these. Oh, that's a dart. That's a dart. This one is good. Yeah. I have no idea how I got this this one, but he this species, the Stefan species, is amazing at making honeycombs and stuff. Yeah. And then I got this. All of these I didn't make, as you can see. These are not stackable. These are not stackable, but I got them from Willy. I got them from Willy. Yeah, because I had so much emeralds. I had so many emeralds, but yeah. As you can see here, he's just standing there. First, I did this. I traded him for that. Then I traded him for a couple of apiaries. Then I traded him. I took 64 emeralds. I had tons of them, and traded him for that. And then princesses to emeralds. I got a million princesses because my quarry got emeralds out of that. And then suddenly, 12 emeralds and one princess gives us this one. This one is a very, very special type of drone, and you can only get them through the villager. You cannot breed to them. You cannot find them in the world. You can only get them through the villager. So that's pretty cool. Oh, and yeah, I've named him Willy, so he doesn't despawn. And up here we got that. We got the yellow combs. We got some dripping combs here, and these that we need to put in our system out here. And we're gonna go out back here, and we're gonna go here. We got the centrifuge, and this here is a ME cover. So we can just do this. Yoink. Where'd it go? There it went. Cool. We need another capacity card. I can see. So now we can just put them in there, and it should, as soon as this one is done, ooh, nice. Zombies dying outside. Oh, yeah. Okay, let's see, can we make another capacity card? C-A-R-D. We need another capacity card. And bam, we can. Sweet. Okay. One capacity card. And now for the icy combs. Nice. So the dripping combs are in here. That. And as soon as this one, the dripping combs are done, it's gonna go over to the icy combs. So sweet. And we can add two more here. Sweetums! Cool. Oh. Completely forgot. Oh, yeah. Put these two up here. H-O-N. Ah, honeydew, yellow tint honey, and honey drops, nice. Okay, there's a lot of different types of honey drops, of course. Yellow colored honey drops, yellow tint honey drops. What the heck? Oh well. A sword king. Oh. Getting none of these cotton balls. Yeah. And whoops. Almost there. course, the quarry is still going. Still going fast. Nice. I'm keeping the cobblestone now because I need to make a new barrel, or a new drum, actually, it's called. I need to make this one, the Bedrockian drum. I just need one of them, but damn, it's costly for these Bedrockian ingots. So out here, within, what is it called? Isn't it an igneous extruder? Yeah, a bucket of water and a bucket of lava gives you unlimited cobblestone. So this one makes compressed cobblestone, double compressed cobblestone, triple, quadruple, quintuple compressed cobblestone, and then the last one, which then will be able to make the bedrockium things off. But yeah, try and figure it. You need 9 cobblestone just to make a double, or a compressed cobblestone. You need 9 compressed, that's 9 times 9. Then you need 9 double, that's 9 times 9 times 9 times 9, or actually 9 times 4, 9 times 8, 9 times 16, 9 times 32. Yeah. So yeah, you can see how much cobblestone it takes. Oh my god. Oh. Pieces, nice. Yeah, everything is running like a son of a bitch. Oh yeah, let's go upstairs. Mistcraft room and Terry's smelter. So yeah, I've made a couple of Mistcraft books. We got some Mistcraft ages to go and have a look at, and I want to show you. I think it's this one. Is this one or is it this one? I think it's this one. Yeah, this is the one. This is the only one. Oh, whew. I was just about to say, damn. I forgot to make the link book, but I didn't. The link book is right here. Yeah. Let's go into Raven mode. This is the only one of the ages that I've made that is actually stable. It doesn't give me a ton of things, but this age is weird as fuck. Look at all these structures that is out here. All of these weird structures, and this is the most gigantic village I've ever seen, with guards no less, and a castle to boot. A village guard here. He's got a bow and arrow. And the villagers are like, I'm gonna sleep here. And they all just sleeping. What the heck is this? Oh, it's a village. He's just slept, but he's inside the rug. What the? Is that a villager? Apparently, yeah. But look, that's a Thaumcraft villager. You know what? We're gonna steal him. Putting these two back up, taking down my... Nope, that's the wrong one. This one is my bag of mobs. Whoops. Sorry about that. Ooh, this is a... Ooh, tiny biomes. Okay, I don't think I have this one. So, does that mean there's a chest down behind here? Nope, there's not. And this is the old... This is the old writing desk. Okay, cool. Head on guard. So yeah, ooh, nice. What is up with you? Yeah, sometimes they that is not good. Okay, let me just yeah, that is not good. I am so sorry about this, guys. But we're gonna have to do something about that. We're gonna have to do something about the whole that dude. This miss over here. Oh shit, up. Ah shit, the only way I can help them is by doing this. Gonna look ugly as fuck, but at least they're not gonna die from this. Cool, and then there was the other pool of black snot over here. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Well, I think this is as good as time as any to say thank you all so very much for watching. And welcome back to a new week of Minecraft Old World Revived. Yeah, I'm gonna... Oh, I still got 10 more. Yeah, well, this is gonna be fun as hell because I'm gonna use these new Mistcraft Aegis. You stupid son of a fudge. Yeah, I'm gonna use these new Mistcraft Aegis here to literally be my new quarry worlds. Is anybody living in here? No. Cool. I'll take my axe to it. Yeah. Thank you all so very much for watching, and as always, catch you on the flip side.